The National Institutes of Health is the nation's medical research agency. Its scientists make important discoveries that improve health and save lives. Many researchers at the NIH focus on basic research that increases our understanding of health and disease.
The basic science that we do here at the NIH will help in tackling human diseases. Major human diseases, such as cancer, cardiovascular disease, neurological disorders such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease.
To answer basic questions such as how cells communicate with each other, or how our organs and tissues form, researchers often use animal models such as fruit flies, roundworms, zebrafish, and frogs. Many people feel we have little in common with these organisms, but at the cellular and molecular level, human beings have much in common with all forms of life. Also, these model organisms are ideal for laboratory work because they are inexpensive, easy to maintain, and have properties that make them ideal to study certain aspects of biology. Dr. Mark Stopfer, a researcher at the Eunice Kennedy Shriver National Institute of Child Health and Human Development in Bethesda, Maryland, uses locusts, grasshoppers, to study neuroscience.
The locust is actually a good animal to use to study certain questions in neuroscience. Even though the insect looks very different from us, its nervous system in many ways is very similar to ours. The nerve cells communicate with each other in pretty much the same way. They use the same sort of electrical and chemical signals to communicate with each other. And they're connected in pretty much the same way. Compared to our brains, they have relatively few nerve cells. And so it's relatively easy for us to get in there and figure out what each cell is contributing to the processing of information. For certain questions, locusts really give us the most value for the research dollar. They're not expensive to raise. We can do experiments on locusts that at the moment can't be done in any other animal in order to answer certain kinds of questions. And we need the answers to those questions if we want to understand how the brain functions.
In his quest to better understand the brain, Dr. Stopfer focuses on one of the brain's many functions, controlling the sense of smell. He's already learned some lessons from the locusts.
It turns out that there's really one best way to process the sense of smell. And wherever you look across the animal kingdom, you see the same types of organizations. And so it's very surprising. It certainly surprised me. But the sense of smell in the insect works very much the way the sense of smell works in us. If we can understand how the sense of smell works in the brain, that will give us clues to how the brain is processing all kinds of complicated forms of information. And one thing we've learned by studying the sense of smell is that groups of nerve cells will suddenly start to fire together in a process called synchrony. They become synchronized. And that's how the brain normally works when it's processing the sense of smell.
Basic research discoveries often have implications for a wide range of fields, including those that may seem unrelated to the original research. In this case, Dr. Stopfer's observations about nerve synchrony might inform research into medical conditions as diverse as dyslexia and epilepsy.
So how's the experiment going?
Synchrony can go bad in the brain. That's called epilepsy when there's too much synchrony. So synchrony has to be controlled. It has to occur within limits. If we can understand how the brain works under normal situations, it'll help us understand how to prevent abnormal situations from occurring.
Most of today's successful drug and medical devices were discovered as a result of basic research, such as that conducted by Dr. Stopfer and other scientists at the NIH. As these scientists pursue basic questions about how life works, they are paving the way for future advances in understanding, diagnosing, treating, or even preventing a wide range of medical conditions.
By trying to uncover the fundamental truth on how everything works, you try to uncover how the human body works. You take information from basic elements, to how cells function, to how whole tissues function, to how an organism functions. And then you try to integrate this information to find out how the human body functions. The unique concentration of intellect, resources, and the system that links basic sciences to translational applications, this is what NIH is all about.